Hi, and welcome to another FSCJ educational video. This video covers a common algebra word problem that can be really tricky to solve.
We have a word problem here that's going to incorporate a couple of very important concepts. We have constant motion in that we have two cars approaching the city of Springfield. One car is approaching from the due east and is traveling at 50 miles per hour and it's 800 miles from Springfield.
And our other car is 1,000 miles due south of Springfield and is approaching at 60 miles per hour.
Now the punchline here is how much time will elapse before these two cars are 700 miles apart?
We need to realize at that moment their distances will be the measure of the hypotenuse of a right triangle.
So not only do we have a constant motion problem, we also have a geometric problem all at the same time.
So at any given time, we would say the distance of car A from Springfield is 800 minus 50x.
Now you're probably saying, well, why minus 50x? Well, remember, for every hour that this car is traveling, it will travel 50 miles. So the distance from Springfield for car A will be the 800 original miles minus the 50 miles per hour times the amount of time the car has been traveling.
For car B, its distance from Springfield would be 1,000 minus 60x because it is traveling at 60 miles per hour.
What we have here is we have the distance from car A squared plus the distance of car B squared is going to equal, remember, C squared, A squared plus B squared equals C squared.
Well, the 700 miles that two cars are apart is C. That is the length of our hypotenuse. So we have an equation that says C squared equals A squared plus B squared.
So the square root of A squared plus B squared will equal C. And in our case, C needs to be 700 miles.
So 700 is going to equal the square root of the distance at any given time of A squared.
Plus, we have the square of the distance of car B, which is going to be 1,000 minus 60x squared. And this is going to equal 700 miles. Once we get to this point, what we have is we have a quadratic equation. And although the numbers are large, the methodology of solving it is really not that difficult. So we're going to leave it here. We hope you've enjoyed this video presentation of this rather interesting word problem.
And please stay tuned for our other FSCJ educational videos.